It's time for the black man to wake up. It's time for us to do something. We've been sitting on our behinds for so long, we don't know what to do as a people. We are leaders. The Most High called us to be leaders on this earth. Right. He called us to rule this earth. Right. You so-called blacks and you Hispanics.
Book of Matthew, chapter 6, verse 9. After this manner, therefore pray ye, our Father, which art in heaven.
Hey, you heard this before, sir? What's your name, bro? Reggie, my name is Yeshua. Nice to meet you, bro. You heard this before? Read it again.
After this manner, therefore, pray ye, our Father, which art in heaven. Hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come.
Thy kingdom come.
Thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven.
You understand what that means, bro? Right, right, yeah. You're on the right line. So it's saying thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth like it is in heaven. So guess what? All this folly you see around us, all these conditions they put on us as a people is gonna be gone when Christ come back. Right. You gotta understand that this ain't gonna last forever. These nations, they're not gonna be above us forever. This is temporary. This captivity we're in today, this is temporary. They're not going to be ruling over us forever. Right. But we have to put in our works for the Most High. He's not just going to give it to us. Give me Luke 7:21. He's not just going to give us the kingdom. You ain't just going to be looking one day and say, oh, here's the kingdom now. I believe in my heart. You know, God is the Most High, and I believe in him. And now is the kingdom. That's not going to be the case. Watch this. Check this out.
The book of Luke, chapter 7 and verse 21.
Bring it up.
And in that same hour, he cured many of their infirmities.
Excuse me. Luke 17:21. So you got to understand, we gotta work towards this kingdom. You have a job to do as an Israelite man. You are no longer a black man. A black man's job is to continue to be a slave in America.
Right.
But an Israelite's job is to wake his people up and repent so right. We can return to our homeland.
Yep.
We got to keep these laws, bro. You got to understand that. But check this out.
The book of Luke, chapter 17, verse 21.
Y'all brothers, listen up as well over here.
Neither shall they say, lo here. Or lo there.
So neither shall we say lo here or lo there. Or this the kingdom right here is coming. It's on its way. No, it's not going to be like that. Christ ain't coming back until you are ready as a people. And guess what, brother? We're not ready right now. We got brothers still, Israelite men, that the Most High God chose to be a special people smoking cigarettes. What's that doing to your body? You're destroying yourself. You're destroying yourself. All you do is drink on the corners. Our people are better than that.
Right.
We just read in Deuteronomy 7:6 that the Most High God chose us to be a special people.
Right.
And guess what? Smoking those cigarettes all dang day, that's not special. There's nothing holy about that. So you got to revert your mind back to what the Most High wants for you. Read on.
For behold, the kingdom of God is within you.
Read it again.
The kingdom of God is within you.
The kingdom of God is within you, so-called blacks and you Hispanics. We got to put in our works. We got to put in work for this kingdom that's coming. That kingdom come that will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Now give me Daniel 7:18. Daniel 7:18. Listen up, black man. This is your job. This is your purpose.
Right.
This is your reason of living to this day.
Right.
Daniel 7:18.
The book of Daniel, chapter 7:18. But the saints of the Most High shall take the kingdom.
Hey, guess what, bro? We are the saints of the Most High.
Right.
You don't know that. When you think of a prophet naturally as a sinful man, not knowing his heritage, not knowing his identity. When you think of a saint, when you think of a prophet, when you think of leaders within this Bible, you think of the so-called white man. But guess what? This ain't got nothing to do with them.
Right.
They're in this Bible, but not in a beneficiary way. But you are a black man if you repent.
Right.
If you get your mind right, the Most High is going to bless you through these scriptures. He's saying, read it again.
But the saints of the Most High shall take the kingdom.
We are going to take the kingdom. This whole earth was made for us. That's what the scriptures say. This whole earth was made for us. So we're going to take this kingdom. It's time for us to wake up. It's time for us to do something as men. What are you men going to do for your people? Your people out here getting shot on a day-to-day basis.
Right.
I just read some online to where it was a 73 fatality within the hospitals. It was a shooting.
Right.
It was a shooting. Black people lined up outside of the hospital not knowing what to do. Our people, we don't care about nothing like that because guess what? It's not happening to me or my family. Guess what? We are one nation.
Right. That's right.
That's how we got to think of ourselves.
Right.
And until we do that, guess what? We're going to stay on the bottom.
Right.
Go back to, matter of fact, read verse 27.
The book of Daniel, chapter 7 and verse 27.
Bring it out.
And the kingdom and dominion.
And the kingdom. So thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. So that's talking about this right here. Read on.
And the greatness of the kingdom.
And the greatness of the whole kingdom. So when we see that kingdom, when we see Christ open up them skies, handing out crowns to the righteous Israelite men, that's what it's talking about. Read on.
Under the whole heaven.
Under the whole heaven. Everybody's going to be under subjection to the Most High.
Right.
Everybody's going to be. This sinful kingdom is not going to last forever.
Right.
Read on.
Shall be given to the people of the saints of the Most High.
Black men, you are the people of the saints of the Most High.
That's right.
You got to see yourself as such. You got to see yourself as more than a nigga.
Right.
You have to change your mind. Give me that. What I want. Change your mind. Repent. You can go to, Acts 3 and 19. Go to that one first.
Bring it up.
You gotta change your mind. Because everywhere on the media, you see women, black women shaking their behinds. You see black men supporting that garbage.
Right.
Why do we stay doing that as a people? We are truly a proverb and a amazement to these other nations. On YouTube, all you see is our people fighting one another. And guess what? To a nigga, that is entertainment. But guess what? We kings.
Right.
This Bible said we are royalty. We're better than that.
Right.
No longer shall we do that as men. We got to lead our people. Read on.
The book of Acts, chapter 3, verse 19.
Bring it
up. Repent ye therefore.
This is talking to you. Repent. Change your mind. Repent ye therefore, read on,
and be converted.
And be converted. You got to be converted. Right now, you're in a sinful state. You got to understand right who you are right now. That's not okay with the Most High. He don't want you to be who you are right now, a sinful man. And we was all there. It's not me looking down on you. It's me trying to lift you up.
Right.
Through these scriptures.
Right.
Read on.
That your sins may be blotted out.
That your sins may be blotted out. Just like in the time of Noah. Noah was, he was teaching. He was trying to tell the people, you need to change. You need to stop being a sinful kingdom. But guess what? They didn't want to listen to him. So what happened? The Most High destroyed the whole earth. All the people died except for Noah and his family. Everybody else on the planet Earth died.
Right.
So guess what? The Most High says one-third of his people is going to make it and two-thirds ain't.
Right.
So if he wasn't playing back then, what makes you think he's playing about that now?
Right.
You got to get serious with this Bible because a lot of death and destruction is coming to this earth.
That's right.
Read on.
When the times of refreshing shall come.
When the times of refreshing shall come. When Christ comes back, like the brother brought up. He ain't coming back with lollipops. He ain't coming back to give everybody hugs on the earth.
Right.
He's coming back to destroy the majority of these sinful people.
That's right.
And set those Israelite men that hearken unto the Most High on top.
Right.
So we can rule these other nations.
Right.
Read on. Matter of fact, give me Romans 12 and 2. Give me Romans 12 and 2. We got to repent, black man. We on this earth for a reason. They ain't going to tell you that on TV. On these MTV, BET, they going to show you movies about Smokey and Friday smoking all dang day, not doing nothing, not understanding who he is. They're going to show you movies like that because that's who they really want you to be.
Right.
They ain't going to put those too many movies like Black Panther out. They ain't going to show you too many movies about you being royalty. You better believe that.
Right.
They did a great job destroying your people. Look at the state of our people today. They did an amazing job, the so-called white man. Because guess what? The chains are off and we are still slaves.
That's right.
That's right.
Read.
The book of Romans, chapter 12, verse 2. And be not conformed to this world.
So that's talking about you again, black man. Black woman, Hispanics. Be not conformed to this world. Be not conformed to this society. This society isn't built for us. That's why we're at the bottom. Right. Guess what society is built for us? The kingdom of heaven.
That's right.
But we got to work for it, like the scripture just said. Read it again.
And be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed.
Be ye transformed. You have to be transformed. You gotta not be the person that you've been your whole life. It don't matter if you're 23 years old, you 32, 58. You got to be transformed before your time is up.
Right.
When your time is up, you ain't been converted. You ain't been transformed. It's too late. It's too late. So now is the time to start, black man. Now is the time to put in work. Put in work for the Most High.
Right. Right?
By the renewing of your mind.
You got to renew your mind. Right now, you're out of order. Right now, our people are out of order. That's why we have black-on-black crime, because we are out of order. Our minds haven't been changed. We are still slaves, so guess what? Mendigo fighting is still occurring on these streets.
Right.
Slavery is still occurring on these streets.
Right.
Them extorting our people, that's still going on, but guess what? You ain't going to see it like that because your mind is on smoking weed. That's all you care about. Your mind is on clubbing all dang day. That stuff is temporary fix.
Right.
It's only going to make you feel good temporarily. But Christ is trying to make you inherit eternal life. Eternal life. What club can give you that? No club can give you that. No drug can give you that.
Right.
Only these laws can give you eternal life.
Right. Right.
Bishop Nathaniel of Israel United in Christ. Please subscribe to our YouTube channels. Stay up to date with our latest events, music, and classroom lessons. IUIC plans to continue visiting different countries where this gospel has not been preached before. IUIC needs your help in pushing this truth. So join us, subscribe to our Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, and podcast, and stay up to date with us. more information, please visit www.israelunite.org.